My duty as an officer is to save human lives.
And action!
We have to show the world that not all of us were like him. Otherwise, this will always be Hitler's Germany.
I was in Germany in early 2002, and I was on a tour of Berlin, and I was taken to the Wendler Block. There's a monument there. It is the only monument to any German soldier who served in World War II. And I became fascinated that these four men, whose names I had never heard, were the only people that were memorialized out of anyone who served in that war.
And that sort of struck a chord with him, and he thought it might be an interesting story to look into. And we started researching it, and he asked if I'd like to write it with him. And so I knew nothing of the subject before that, and I started researching it just, you know, based on this one little experience Chris had.
And through these four people discovered this large network of resistance in which they were involved, and that they were not the only one. But through Stauffenberg, we discovered that there was this humanity within Hitler's Germany that had never been depicted before.
I think there's sort of a misconception about Germans during World War II, and especially Germans that served during World War II, that all Germans in World War II were Nazis. And it became clear very early on in this process that that wasn't the case.
My grandfather wasn't a Nazi. He was an officer in the Wehrmacht. He was deeply opposed to many of the Nazi ideals. But he was a soldier, you know, and he was convinced that that was a good thing. In fact, he believed that his being a soldier and an officer was a service to his country.
As I started to look at this story and the story of the German resistance, I started to discover that it was not so black and white, it was not so cut and dry. It's extremely rich and extremely textured, and I think more than anything, it's extremely exciting. We finished the script and just sat on it. We would tinker with it here and there, put it away, go on to other projects, and always come back to it. We were not in any hurry to submit it to studios. We weren't in any hurry to get it made. We wanted to find the right place and the right people who were really interested in the material.
In the summer of 2006, Bryan had actually read the script, and he approached Chris and said that he would be interested in directing it. And if we were going to give it to somebody to do, we felt very comfortable giving it to Bryan.
Chris and I have grown up together. And we've known each other since our parents ran for township committee back in Princeton Junction, New Jersey. And they had worked together on The Usual Suspects, and we were looking for a chance to work together again, had been for quite a while.
He and I grew up together watching World War II movies, and we've always been fascinated in the period. We've always been fascinated with Nazi Germany, and you can see the influence of that fascination in Bryan's earlier work, obviously At Pupil, the opening of X-Men.
We used to make war films in my backyard. In fact, we would, on the set of Valkyrie, we would joke about it. We said, wow, now we got better uniforms, better helmets, real planes, and Tom Cruise.
Action.
Promised Abraham he would not destroy Sodom if he could find just 10 righteous men. I have a feeling that for Germany, it may come down to one.
First time I met Bryan Singer, it was actually at the Mission Impossible premiere. And I'd just seen Usual Suspects a bit before that. And we started talking. I said, I'd really like to work with you. So years passed, and this script came along, and Bryan said, I'm very interested in directing you in this piece. And they came to my house and gave me the book, the biography, and I started doing research on this time period.
How Tom ended up in this film all came about somewhat organically. When it was time to go out with the script, we went to United Artists and met with Tom Cruise as the head of a studio. And it was when Bryan brought out some of the research material and laid down a photograph of Stauffenberg, and everybody was just sort of looking at the picture.
Well, Tom Cruise is dream casting for this role. He does look very similar. His core is very dedicated to truth, whether it's filmmaking or in his private life. I think there's great similarity between the core of what Stauffenberg was all about and what Tom Cruise is all about.
I think it's a tremendous coup to have Tom Cruise play Klaus von Stauffenberg. It's, I think, casting kind of made in heaven. Apart from the fact that it gives the film opportunities that the film would otherwise not have. Millions of people will watch this movie because they want to see Tom Cruise, because he's one of the most popular actors in the world.
Can these men see it through?
Come and hear what they have to say.
Bryan Singer is such a terrific director. Tom Cruise is so brilliantly cast, and Chris McQuarrie and Nathan Alexander did something that you couldn't put down in this screenplay. So I'm not surprised that so many really very talented people joined up.
Well, we really cast every part very specifically, very carefully, and wanted the best performance we could possibly get.
I don't think you can put enough value on familiar faces in a film. There's just an air of legitimacy added to a film when you've got actors you recognize that you feel comfortable with. When you see Terence Stamp and Kenneth Branagh and Bill Nighy up there, these are quality actors that help you believe that it's real.
Not only are all of them great actors, each one is pitch perfect playing the person they are depicting. They're all playing real people from history, and so it's fascinating to be standing in a room and see them brought to life.
I'm engaged in high treason with all means available to me. Can I count you in?
For anything, sir.
To do this story justice was to try and be as authentic as possible. We went into in-depth research, books, libraries, DVDs. Fortunately here, when we came to Berlin, there's actually a media archive, which was very helpful.
Every day, for the months that we prepared the film, it just never ended. The research, the learning, the education, the edification. So every day and every department informed the film. And we were all going for the same thing, that authenticity.
Bryan was constantly searching for what was authentic and at the same time something we had never seen before.
All movies require the work of a great team, production designer, photography, art director. There's a richness to the costumes by Joanna Johnson. Everything was custom made from the boots to the hats to the emblems, and it shows.
Joanna, who I've worked with fortunately many times, she's brilliant, and it's a very challenging task to do this, but when I put the uniform on, I repelled it at first, actually.
Put on these clothes and you immediately, you know, you're not sitting like I'm sitting now, you're just, it puts you up right away, and your body is moving differently, your head is not shaking like that anymore, and it does something to you.
Many of the German military had a very strong sense of how important their look was, how important the uniform was. Aside from pride in the uniform, was a sense of how good they looked and what an impact it could make. You start to feel that once you put those boots on and once you see the detail that they took with how they presented themselves.
And then the swastika is also weird because you get used to that. But once you see it all around and you put up a ton of flags, and so you just get used to them.
There's certain parts where we have lots of flags. For example, at the Mess of Berlin, there's one scene and we actually had 120 swastikas flying.
And so we shot at actual locations. We shot in Berlin.
And there isn't any other place that we would shoot this movie besides Berlin.
The scene today is that after Stauffenberg put Valkyrie in place, so what we see is a street blocking with troops of the Ostdeutschland Guard.
It's called the Messegelände. It's a nice, nice old Nazi building. And so we are, as Berliners, we are so used to the place, you know, just like being there, and suddenly you have all these Nazi flags, and it's, it felt surreal to the Berliners as well, believe me. You know, and I noticed like all the people like walking by or driving by, they were like kind of like in shock a little bit, you know.
One woman came to one of our locations who was there, who was living there when it happened, and she was astonished.
I didn't know that there will be scenes about this movie. But then when I came and saw the flags, I thought, my God, this looks so very well known to me.
She saw the Wehrmacht soldiers. We had 300 of them out that day. And she sat behind the monitor and watched us shoot a scene.
And roll camera, action!
Being able to film this story in the place where it happened, I think has fueled everybody from the director and writers to the actors with a kind of immediacy and a sort of almost like the ghosts of times gone by are pulling strings and infusing everything that people do with the history of the story.
This is a military operation. Nothing ever goes according to plan.
The Pendler Block is such a special place, or place of special sanctity, you might even say, because the four officers, Stauffenberg and the other three, were shot here.
Initially, I wanted to shoot at the Pendler Block because it was authentic and because I had had a wonderful experience touring the Resistance Museum there. And I felt that since they had shot there before, it would be welcome, and then we had difficulties.
The question was, would the movie sort of mirror this special meaning, or would it be contrary to the special meaning?
I think there were a lot of misunderstandings initially. I think there were maybe perhaps some sort of knee-jerk reactions to Hollywood coming, and what was Hollywood going to do with this very German story that Germans are quite familiar with and quite rightly proud of.
The decision had been passed that shooting here would be a problem because of the special meaning of the place, the special sanctity or dignity of the place.
I know that Tom Cruise himself took a huge lead role in getting together behind the scenes with policymakers, just getting to a point where we could get to the table with the government officials and be able to explain what it is we were trying to do.
Well, it was so important that I wouldn't have made the film if I couldn't shoot in those locations.
We had a discussion also with some people of this production here, and my impression immediately was that they were doing a very thorough, thoughtful, and good piece of work.
We just wanted to say a few words, honoring the occasion and honoring the place that we're shooting.
We started the evening with a moment of silence and with statements by Tom Cruise and the producers and the writers of the significance of being there.
Now, obviously, it's to be here tonight is important for this film. And again, I want to thank everyone involved, all the efforts to get us here, the efforts to make this picture. It's a very personal film for all of us involved. And it is a great honor for me to play this character, to represent the spirit of this man.
It didn't hit me until we were there. Until we did the first few takes of the executions. It didn't hit me till that moment how happy I was that we had that location.
I've had so many German members of our crew come over and they have thanked me for making this happen, for shooting here, especially for shooting here.
I've stood on the spot where my character was shot. I've stood in his office, the very room where all of this takes place.
To see these actors, who are very dedicated to their role, stand in the place where these characters stood that night. And here we were shooting this with firing squad. There they are, pit of sand, as it was.
Hey! Ludwig's sacred Germany!
You know, I really can't find the words to articulate what those evenings were like, and to be there and to think about that. It was invaluable. You can't qualify what it was like to shoot in those places.
It shows for the first time to the world that not every German was a killer, not every German was a Nazi, and that there has been some resistance. That's a very, very important point.
And I find that as brave, if not braver, a choice to oppose Adolf Hitler when you are German than someone from the outside who's come to stop him.
Every project I take, there's a reason behind it. It's in some way cathartic for me. I give that year or more of my life to the film unconditionally for a reason.
I think that everybody wants to identify in a positive way with your country, and that was stolen from us. This movie, I hope, it's going to change the view on our country in a very strong way.
It was intense at times and very difficult, but also mixed in with the exhilaration of making a movie and a movie on this scale. So it was also, thrilling.